Hey guys, it's Melanie. Happy Wednesday. So today I have an in-depth, kind of longer-term skincare review to share. I have been using these particular products since back, I think I received them right at the beginning of February. And as soon as I got them in the mail, I incorporated them into my skincare routine and have been using them ever since. So it's definitely been at least a couple of solid months, and I feel like I am at a point where I can tell you whether these products have made any significant changes in my skin, what those changes are, do I see myself using these particular products long term, stuff like that. So that's what we're talking about today. And the products that we are talking about are from Dr. Loretta. I actually did a little bit of a skincare giveaway with these products as well. And I believe the winner was Lindsay. So Lindsay, if you're watching this, if you have since hopefully received the products and started using them, definitely let me know your thoughts down below in the comments as well. But so I'm really excited to share my thoughts with you guys, because typically when I get skincare products either sent to me or whether I purchase them, I always look at them and think, where is the best place to incorporate these products? And one of the areas that I have neglected for pretty much most of my adult life in terms of caring for the skin is my neck. I like to call it my neck meat. I have always washed my neck, you know, like at night when I take off my makeup, I usually always, you know, like wash my neck area as well, just to make sure that I get any makeup off of there. And every morning when I'm in the shower, I do take the time, or I have in the past always taken the time to wash my neck. But I've never really brought a lot of the skincare that I use on my face down onto my neck, because I think I always took for granted that my neck looked pretty good for my age. However, within the last year or two, I have started noticing some signs of aging on my neck, some loss of firmness. Sometimes it can be a little bit more dry. I think my neck is the only area on my body that is not oily somehow. That sounds disgusting, but I have the oiliest scalp, I have the oiliest face. I typically don't get super dry on like the skin on my body either, but yeah, it's kind of the one area where I've always been like, eh, it's fine. However, when I received these products, I specifically thought about using them on my neck, because one of the things that I did want to incorporate into my neck skincare routine was a retinol. And the concentrated firming serum in this little set that Dr. Loretta sent is the is their concentrated firming serum, which has a 0.5% retinol. So a really nice low concentration. And you know, I always advise, if you are starting out with a retinol, if you've never used one in the past, definitely start out with some lower concentrations and sort of ease your way up. You know, for me, I started with, I think on my face, with a 1% retinol. I just kind of went for it there, but that area of my body is pretty tough in terms of being able to handle skincare, so that wasn't a huge issue. But I knew that there was no way that I would be able to use my tretinoin that I now use on my face on my neck. So I figured this is a great place to start. So I was using the anti-aging repair moisturizer along with the concentrated firming serum on my neck for the past couple of months. And we're gonna talk about the changes that I've seen, all that kind of stuff. By the way, the set, which is still available, I will link all of this stuff down below for you guys. Dr. Loretta is available in several different places, so I'll be sure to link a few different vendors down below. Dermstore, for example, I bought a refill of this. So this is the Dr. Loretta Gentle Hydrating Cleanser with Marine Peptides. This originally came in my kit as well, but I finished that within the first couple of months. This was my morning shower cleanser for a while. So when I finished it, I missed it so much that I immediately repurchased it off of Dermstore. So this is a great cleanser. I obviously haven't opened this one. I have another cleanser in the shower right now that I'm using, but this one is fantastic. If you've never tried it, and especially if you have sensitive skin, you need to look into this. It's a wonderful, wonderful cleanser. But let's talk mostly about these two products. So The concentrated firming serum, like I said, has a 0.5% retinol. By the way, Dr. Loretta is a cruelty-free skincare brand. She is a board-certified dermatologist, and I really kind of like the philosophy of her company. She has, she's done a lot of research, and I like the fact also that she includes her daughters in her business as well. Just always kind of makes me happy to see that. But definitely go read up about Dr. Loretta. She has an amazing background in terms of her education and the research that she's done. And she formulates all of her products herself. And spoiler, they've worked really well for my skin. So I think she has a great line. So the key ingredients in this particular retinol, I do have it pulled up here. I'm just going to read some of this stuff for you guys. The 0.5% retinol that she has included in here is meant to boost collagen production to reduce the appearance of fine lines and prevent wrinkles. It speeds cell turnover to remove stores of pigment from the skin. It brightens the tone. It unclogs the pores and makes them appear smaller and helps to reduce breakouts. So if you are using this on your face, this might be a great thing to incorporate if you are dealing with those issues on your face. As you guys know, I am now using tretinoin on my face. This also contains bioidentical skin lipids, which replenish moisture to provide instant radiance and luster and help keep skin well hydrated, even in dry climate controlled environments and during seasonal cold weather. So the ingredients in here are fairly simple. It's a pretty short little list here, so I'll be sure to link this down below. Before you choose to purchase this serum, always make sure that there's nothing in there that could potentially irritate your skin if you have some allergies or sensitivities to certain ingredients. So I don't see anything in here that is of concern to me anyway, or what I would assume would be a concern to anybody else. In fact, I think those of you that have a more sensitive skin type, I feel like because of the lipids that are in here, it's actually pretty soothing. And I think that even someone with a more sensitive skin type could probably use this without much issue. So they say to start out using this, like, you know, most directions, use it every other day, kind of work your way up to using it daily. They also tell you that you can use it twice a day. I have only been using it once a day, and I have been using it at night. So every night after I wash my face, you know, I will put my toner, whatever that toner that is, on my neck, let that absorb. And then I've been going in with the concentrated firming serum and then topping it with the anti-aging repair moisturizer. So this moisturizer is fantastic. I have also used this on my face. A little bit does go a long way. And essentially what I do is just apply I think I use about the equivalent of like 5-6 drops or something like that. And I've been doing a little bit of like a neck massage and just working the product in and then topping it with this. And basically that's it. That's my neck skincare routine for the most part. So what I have noticed over the last couple of months since incorporating these two items specifically in my neck routine is that I have noticed that this line that I have here, I think it's probably from sleeping on my stomach for years. I'm finally not doing that anymore because of this sleeping glow pillow, but this line was definitely getting pretty deep. And one of the things that I've noticed is that within the last couple of months, it looks much less pronounced. Now it's still there, and I don't think it will ever go away completely because it's pretty deep, but it has softened pretty significantly. Another thing that I have noticed is that I am getting some very gentle but very effective exfoliation on my neck. So the skin feels a lot less rough. It feels like it's smoother. The tone, the brightness, everything just looks so much better. Also, I don't know if you guys remember, but I had an eczema breakout here and here on my neck, what was it, about a month and a half ago maybe. And that was super frustrating because whenever I get an eczema attack like that, it does leave a little bit of a scar, like some hyperpigmentation for a little bit. And that is completely gone. And in fact, I feel like this moisturizer, especially the anti-aging moisturizer, helped to soothe that eczema breakout really, really nicely. So there's no more darkness or anything like that. And I feel like my neck just, it looks and feels so much just nicer. Like it's soft, it's hydrated. I feel like the tone, everything just looks much more improved. So for me, I have definitely noticed a difference in my skin from using these products just once a day. I'm a little hesitant to ever use a retinol during the daytime, even though I do use an SPF all over. I've just always kind of stuck to the rule of retinols at night, and then, you know, sometimes I will do some AHAs during the day, but you really want to be careful with anything that's going to sensitize your skin to the sun. I've told this story before, but I've made the mistake before of putting an AHA body lotion on my arms before going and setting up a wedding. And I forgot to bring my SPF with me, so I was just out there working away. And let me tell you, when I was done, I was a lobster. Like, my skin was just so, sorry, I thought Penny was in here. I don't know what that noise does. My skin was just so red and irritated from the sun. I mean, just always protect your skin, but especially if you are using a retinol during the daytime, make sure that you use a good solid SPF to top it off. But overall, these products have been fantastic for my neck. I love how gentle they are. I do definitely see myself repurchasing, especially the retinol in the future. I feel like the anti-aging moisturizer, I really like it, but I feel like I have some other moisturizers that I have in my collection that I feel like are probably just as good, but they do pair really nicely together. There is a kit. I don't know if that kit is just on her website, but you get the full size of the cleanser, the moisturizer, as well as the retinol for, I think, $185. So this is a higher-end skincare brand. The products are a little bit more expensive. The serum by itself is $80. But if you shop through places like Dermstore, there's always a pretty decent cash back with Rakuten. And then they're oftentimes they're having a sale of some sort. So I would really recommend checking this out if you are looking for something for your neck, especially because, like I said, a lot of us choose to ignore that area. And I feel like there's a couple areas on your body that give away your age more so than even your face, and that is your neck as well as the back of your hands. So overall, the texture of this is really nice. It does have those really nice lipids in there that give it this almost like velvety feel. So there's the serum right there. A little bit goes a long way, but you can see that it just has this really nice slip to it. There is it dimethiconol? There is a type of, yes, dimethiconol. So there is a type of silicone in here, but, and also some soybean sterols, but you guys, the texture of this is lovely. And you can see that has now completely absorbed into my skin. It absorbs very, very quickly. It doesn't have like a greasy feel afterwards at all. And a little bit goes a long way. I would then top this off if it was my neck with the moisturizer. I'll show you guys the texture of the, has a really nice, it's more of a lotion type texture, so it's not too heavy, but you can see that there. It just goes so perfectly with the retinol. Absolutely lovely together. For me, the changes have been noticeable. I'm definitely going to be finishing this up. I think I have, I think I'm all like probably down to about here. So a little, it's hard to tell because this bottle is, By the way, it's a glass bottle. It's really nice and opaque. I think I'm to right about here. So yeah, I do see myself repurchasing this. I think there's one new retinol that I just got that I want to try on my neck as well. So I may be taking a break after May to test that other one, but I will be coming back to this. I will be finishing it and I will be repurchasing it myself. I think it's a fantastic product and I think it's really worth checking out. So let me know if you guys have any questions down below. I'll put the links for the products separately as well as the kit that I mentioned in the description box as well. Go check out some of the Dr. Loretta products. I think they have a really great lineup. All their products are very gentle. They're super effective. I love that they're cruelty-free and I love that they are a women-owned business. That really definitely appeals to me as well. So thank you so much for taking the time to watch today. I hope this video was helpful. Leave me any questions down below in the comments. Have a great rest of your day and I'll see you tomorrow.